I like to study, in the very broad sense, I like to study the foundations and the limits of computers and what they can do. My particular focus is on communication between computers. And over there in particular, I'm interested in questions about reliability when there's communication going on. When two computers talk to each other, there are various stages at which you can have unreliability. The classical question that was probably looked at from the time 1940s onwards, when we started building or even conceiving the first communicating and computing devices, was just that the bits that are, that they are transmitting from one computer to the other might get flipped, and you don't want to somehow act on an incorrect interpretation or understanding of what was sent. I think a modern setting that I'm very curious about, and that should be where I think it's very important to the world at large, is that computers are also working with a lot of common context. And they try to use this common context and say, well, I don't need to repeat the context. I will just tell you some new statements which rely on the past context. So communications are short, but the contexts are not always perfectly shared. So I might be running an operating system which is slightly different than yours. And as a result, an app that you might run that I suggest to you might actually run incorrectly. And there are many cases where my phone suddenly freezes and runs over, and that's probably because I've loaded a collection of apps which were collectively incompatible with each other. We've been getting a better and better handle on it, but mostly it has been by ad hoc mechanisms. But when it comes to communication, I don't see that computers are better than humans. I think there's a lot of mismatch. So I thought it would be a wonderful opportunity to try to understand what is it that humans are incorporating into their, you know, organically evolved design of communication methods, languages, and try to understand how to overcome, how humans are overcoming it. Maybe if we can build a computer analog of the same, that would be very fascinating and very useful. So not a particular problem, that there's a class of problems that I really, really would like to understand. I like to understand all the peculiarities of human languages and try to understand what is the mathematical basis of this. A very interesting phenomenon, for example, is that when humans communicate with each other, they end up reusing the same word and repurposing it to mean something else. Why do we do it? Why don't we invent a new word when you want to, you know, use it for a new purpose? I mean, I never made a particular conscious choice about what I wanted to do as a computer scientist. It was just something that I eased into by other circumstances. I cannot possibly imagine what else might actually fit my thing. Today, it's everything in my life. Because of my interest in communication, objects which are close enough that we can at least imagine a round-trip delay within a lifetime would be important, and many rounds of communication would make it even better. So Mars, let's go with that.